Well, there are Mises, and I don't look like I'm very loud today. So I'm just gonna double check my volume to make sure that I am not currently talking without having any kind of action going on. It kinda looks like I am. Yeah. No? Wait, is this not... Oh, hold on. No, it's fixed. Okay. Actually, it looks fine now. I think I'm fine now. I think I'm fine. Hi! Anyway, there are Mises. they were being social, so I figured they might as well just come out here and say hi. Oh my god, this is very warm though, so I'm gonna take this off and mess up my hair. There we go. I'm just gonna have the Mises live back here in the hoodie. Hi, how are you doing? I hope you're doing well. Oh my god, you two are so warm. I had a player who thought we didn't start a session on Sunday for 20 minutes after the start time because his headphones weren't entirely plugged in. Whoops! Like, are we gonna start soon or what? Like, yeah, we've been trying to talk to you for, like, forever. Ow, can you take that paw away? That one, thank you. Ow, thank you. They have very sharp claws, let me tell you. Here you go. Here's some candy. Hey, you. Get back. Have some candy. Yes, Mises. As I said, they were being social, so I figured they might as well just hang around for a little bit before we... fully dive into this. Or rather, while we dive into this, I guess we should say. But yes, if I'm reading my meters correctly, my voice is now acceptable volumes. Yes, I really, really should install Jack, which is basically a virtual mixer where every audio stream becomes its own thing, and you can treat each input in each program as its own input, which would make everything so much easier for me. It's just that I haven't been arsed to set up Jack, which is quite a lot of work. And I also, the thing is, if I set up Jack and it doesn't work the way I want, I've basically broken my audio for stream, which is not great. So that's why I haven't done it yet. I prompted with when last we left our heroes for the third time, and he perfectly timed, started singing, and then realized we'd been talking, he came back and said, yes, we left our heroes in the middle of a musical episode. Please summarize the whole of winter for characters in song. No, you didn't want to say hi to chat? Aw, come on. Alright, fine. Be that way. Anyway, before I get fully distracted here,
we're going.
What's this? Oh no. Oh no. Oh no! How do I change that back? You have such a big moose compared to the others. So you've done Jack about Jack. Correct. That is entirely correct. I've done absolutely Jack about Jack. Oh no. Hold up. No. Okay, good. For a second there, I thought I was being crazy. But I'm not crazy. I'm just slightly insane. I think someone found some candy. At the moment the moose came towards the camera, I heard a frustrated meow from the hallway. Someone found some candy up here. I can hear nom 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 nom. Om nom 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 nom. Say, on your Twitter post that relates to your job, did you turn off comments from people you don't follow? Solar Cat in Ethnis was surprised the post didn't have any comments. I did not. I guess the anime fans decided just not to reply. Which was a bit weird. Also, this should be probably renamed to Worldanvil, because otherwise I won't know what it is. There was peace in our time. There was indeed peace in our time. Okay. So what I'm gonna do today is, because I don't have a brain today. My brain is inexistent today. So I'm not going to do the whole PDF thing today. I'm going to instead start moving items, weapons and armor primarily, from the old blocks system over to the new blocks system so that I can remove the old broken ass block. Template. I mean, they can hover over your username and read your job description, and most of them said, oh bleep, kind of hard to argue against him. I guess. But some people don't possess the intelligence to do even that, so. Do I have a test article in Dark Shadows? I do not think I do, but I do have a lorem ipsum. So we're going to have a look at a lorem ipsum. And start adding a few templates to that one. Edit article. Also, apparently I have a lot of notifications that I should probably look at. There are Mises. So, Lorem Ipsum needs a block. So I need to find a block first before I do anything else. That's not blocks, that's notifications. Holy comments. Oh, it's Lorraine. I should read that later. Arming sword, maybe? Yes. Let's take that. That is going to be one block. And then we're gonna have a row. Coal. Excuse me, how do you spell coal again? My comment was just me being abused about the Discord bug uncovering my fanfic that needs polishing. I see. Yeah, it threw me back like months and I was like, oh right, we had this conversation. Oh, she wrote fanfics. I should probably read that again. And I did. Padded mail. This should be one of them. And then we should have Hey. Go easy with the claws, little lady. You can be cozy. Oh, by the way, You haven't seen this, probably. Come on. Come on. Don't be that girl. If you look at her right ear... Oh, well, I should probably do this. If you look at her right ear... I'm trying to show them something. Can you cooperate? You can see she has a nick in the lower part of her right ear. Okay, never mind. She doesn't want to. But she has a nick in the lower part of her right ear, which is from the injury from the fight. But she's okay. So, and it's fully healed now. So she doesn't even have any, like, any swelling or any redness or anything. So thankfully she didn't get infected and she's okay. She's just, she has a battle scar in her ear now. So the Mises all live separate because apparently introducing them was not going to happen. We need one more block. And the question is, what should I take?
Nani?
No, that's for the new one. Wait, what am I... Hey, hold up. What am I doing here? I'm linking the old blocks right now. Why am I doing that? What was my thought with doing that? Did I even have a thought with that? That is the question. Yeah, these are the old ones. They're so broken. Oh god, they're so broken. Also, hold up, didn't I fix these? Or did Dimmy change the name of the classes? He probably did. Oh well, I'm gonna have to fix that later. These are not supposed to look like this. Why am I linking the old blocks, though? I must have had a reason for that. Oop! Hi, Nina! But I'm not convinced what my idea was. Ow! Seriously, do I have to cut your claws? Jesus. No. I do honestly not remember why I would link the old blocks. I think what I was trying to do was link the new blocks. And for that, I need to have something that was made in the new blocks. And in order to do that, I should have to create a few things that are in the new... So armor doesn't have anything. Weapons doesn't... I'm keeping the moose company by the table. I updated his playground. He has lots to do now. Oh, well, I'm keeping the moose company too. As you can probably see. Ah! Ooh! There are two of them. They are currently cooperating to... slash my neck. They have very, very sharp claws today. They are so very... Scooty and explory. Okay, fine. So we don't have anything. In that case, let's just start making new things. I'm gonna go into edit this one. Oh, hey. Hi.
I believe that this nation should commit itself to achieving the goal of landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to the Earth.
Are you gonna go back? Thank you. Really? I send one moose back and then the other one comes out. These Mises. I need a way to keep track of this, of what I've done and what I haven't done. And for that, I really need to check this world, I think, and go into the blocks here. No, not the images, dude, the stat blocks, thank you. Padded mail. No, wait. I have, these are the new ones. So I have padded mail. I have longsword. Okay, good, 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 good. So what was the first one? The first one was an arming sword. So we're just gonna do the longsword. Longsword? Is that what we're gonna say? There's a padded mail. Yep. And then we need a second one. I guess I could check the community sheets list to see everything. That's what I could do. I'm smart. I have brain. I have smarts. A laser pistol, sure. Now, but we kind of need... hop over there. We kind of need an ammunition. It's going to be arrows later, but... you do that. Okay, fine. You're just gonna be that way. All right, fine. That's cool, I guess. Yeah, that's better. Now we just need to fix this. This mess. This is what we're gonna fix later. I did my first break and I got 404. Yay! That is the fun part of doing templates and stuff. You break everything. Let's just make a new one. This is gonna be the no, that one. That's gonna be the list of blocks. You are not cooperating, lady. Thank you. I'm trying to think what would be the best way to see all of these. If I just searched for item template, would that give me all of them? That would give me absolutely zero of them, apparently. Well, that's cool, I guess. Also doesn't work. Shit. I need to figure out how to do this. Also, another thing I need to figure out is how to remove systems from your world and get rid of these things, because they're a little bit annoying now that I have my own. Aha! This is how you do it. Here's all the things that we need to move. Okay, and today we're moving what? I have fed all the animals. Transfer melee weapons. So. Melee. These are all the things we need to move today, which is easy. We just need to go do this, I guess. I was lured away by banana bread. That's interesting. Banana bread sounds slightly tasty. Now is the question. Is this the new one? It should be this one. Yeah. Arming sword. What type of thing is it? It is a melee weapon. It does not use ammunition, it has no ammo variants, and it uses... I probably should link these, shouldn't I? Fine. Fine. Trades and skills. And this would be then what? Balanced one-handed weapons? Block link? It is, with chocolate chips and then smeared a slab of peanut butter onto it. Sounds tasty. Trader! Oh god, this is way more complicated than I thought. Trader would be what? B and U22. Price was group 9. Yes. G9. No, not price. Group 9. There you go. G9. Terrible breakfast, but tasty. You know, that's usually fine. 2.5 pounds. Why did I mention... Oh, actually, I'm measuring pounds because Dark Shadows uses pounds. Not British or American pounds, but... medieval pounds. I guess I should keep doing that. 2.5 pounds. Description. Copy. Does 3 slash damage. 2 piercing, 1 blunt, and no energy damage. And it inflicts 3 shock. Is that really so? Sure. How many kilograms is that for calculating a PC's in inventory? 1 medieval pound is about 0.5 kilo. It is the closest approximation. 0.5 kilo is 500 grams, and a bowl pound, as they're called, is 425 grams. So it's really, really close. Tags. This is going to be medieval, melee, one-handed, weapon, balanced. It's gonna be here. Mises. Okay, cool. View the sheet and then create another one. Just want to see that it looks good. It looks excellent. Almost. Except for the balanced one-handed weapons. As one approximates modern pounds to 0.5 kilo-ish, I can work with that. Yeah. It is a pretty handy approximation. I really should... Hi, Moose. Stop it. You're not helping. I'm trying to operate my computer mouse while there's a mouse on my hand. I'm trying to make her not escape. Hey, hey. Thank you. Q. You're really in escaping moves today, aren't you? Light balanced weapons commonly swung with one hand. There is now a mouse on the microphone. Come on. Stop being such... No! Get off the microphone. Stay there. Ah! Mises. Are you serious right now? Get up here. Thank you. Can't you just go to sleep like your sister instead of being such a freaking escaping moose? What was the next one? Matka. Blah, blah, blah. Why was that so hard to pronounce? Matka. No. Should I remove these before I... Moose wants to sing. I guess. Should I? Reach. I forgot the reach. Now that I think about it, I forgot the reach. Farming. No. Good evening, Lady Dardis. I hope thou art doing well. Farming. Weapons and armor. Zip. Arming sword. I need to edit that one. Edit. Shito. Reach. Normal. I forgot. And now we have a Matka. Matka. Which is a melee weapon. It uses balanced one-handed weapons, which should be that one. It is relatively common. It is the same. The price, however, I have no idea about. Arming sword. Right, should I delete this? I should probably delete this. Let's delete this. I'm okay, except for the stupid union and unemployment center hunting my... Oh my god. Oh, that is the worst. Goodbye. Matska. It is group 9. G9. It's the same as an arming sword. The weight... 30 pounds, slightly heavier. Description. Single-edged messers. Increased hand protection are a Gimron weapon, but have spread to most of the northern world. These Matka, as they're called, are extremely common among richer commoners who can afford to carry them for self-defense. Yes. And the stats? 4-2-1-2. 4-2-1-2. A scheisse. They also have a parry value that I should probably fill out. Was it 4? Yes. And the reach is close. It's shorter than an arming sword. This is gonna be medieval. Melee one-handed balanced. I've had the trouble since I ended my unemployment in October last year. Oh, that's annoying. Here, have a cute mouse to cheer you up as she escapes. Oh well. I have to do the parry value for the arming sword, which I now remember. I deleted the sheet, so I don't have that anymore. But we should be able to watch that anyway by looking here. Let's reload this page. Thank you. Matka. No, arming sword. It has a parry value of 3. Ha! I remember. Matka should be saved. And then I need to open the arming sword and add the parry value. Just at the end. Parry value of 3. There, 3. Now, let's have a look at that. Skill reached parry. Perfect.
That is the way I wanted it.
I fucked up. But. I can make a new one by doing that.
Create no!
There you go. Saber! Sabre. It's also a balanced thing. And it's pretty rare, right? Yeah, it's rare. Availability, rare. Traders are the same though, right? Bazaar and Master Weaponsmith, yes. The price, G10. Yep. Quality normal, weight 2.3 pounds. The description says sabers are rare and used primarily by mounted warriors in the Gimaran Desert. Single-edged, heavily curved blades designed mainly for devastating slashes and lance-like thrusts when on horseback. Or in their case, wolfback. Slash is probably 4. 4-1-1-1-1. Okay. 4-1-1-1. Parry 4? Yep. See, I know my shit. Normal reach. Medieval melee one-handed weapon balanced. Boom. Done.
Easy.
Create another. And delete the old one. Because it is ugly.
And it is...
I don't know the word. I was looking for a word, but it escaped me. Short sword. Doesn't really exist. That is an arming sword, so this is more like a sax. Mm. I guess it is a cheaper weapon. I guess we can keep it. Come on. Go home. So, short sword, which is a melee weapon. It is balanced one-handed weapons. It is very car. Actually, no, it's normal. Trader is the same. The price is actually G8. I hate it when I do that. When I accidentally save weight, it shouldn't be that much. It's like, what, 1.5 pounds? That's a flimsy sword. Really? Alright, whatever, if you say so. Short swords, blah blah blah, really replaced by matkas. Here's the problem, I need the link for the matka. I have to go to edit sheet, go to the description and find... Oh, sweet mother of Christ. Why did I do that? When I could just use... What? I am so confused at my choices here. Block link. S. That should be all we need. The greater hammer section, the less it is, the better stuff. Yeah. Now we need the values, which was 3, 2, 1, 1, right? Нет. Oh. Back out. 3, 2, 1, 1. Yeah. Parries 3. Reaches close. Das war alles. Medieval, blah, 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 blah. This is the most determined mouse I have ever seen. Do you want to go home instead? Or do you just want to explore the desk? Is that what you want to do? Fine, explore the desk. Create another. And delete this. Meanwhile, her sister has fallen asleep back here. Why can't you be more like your sister? Just calm and chill. The chillest mouse. Side sword. It's a Vengerian weapon. It is a balanced melee weapon. It requires the same skill. It is rare, I'm pretty sure. Yep. But it is sold in the same places, yeah? Yep. It is, however, very expensive. 4 times the price of a normal arming sword. The side sword. Side sword is a highly developed sidearm designed originally for Benjarian town guards. I'm in the wrong world. For town guards, it is a very stiff blade that tapers heavily towards a fine point. The combination of blade stiffness and the sharp taper makes it a very nimble blade with great thrusting capabilities. The complex swept hilt offers excellent hand protection and makes for a decent bludgeoning tool. £2.50, right? If I saw correctly. Yes. Or an... Oh, numbers. 2, 3, 2, 1. 2 slash, 3 pierce, 2 blunt, 1 shock, 3 parry? No, 4. 4 parry and normal. There we go. Medieval melee one-handed weapons. Blasted. Blasted. No, balanced. Balanced is the word. Create another. Delete the old. Be gone. Rapier! The pinnacle of dual weapons. Rapier. Type melee weapon. Skill, however, is dual weapons. And we need to find that, but I'm just going to paste the description first. And then I'm going to open this one again because we have the blocks list here. And scoot the mouses back. Rapier. No. Dual. Dual weapons. Skill required is block link. Availability very rare, I'm pretty sure. Oh, it's just rare. Okay. Rare. Trader is pretty much just a master weaponsmith. Yes. So U22. And it's expensive as balls. G11. Or is it G12? G12. Holy crap. So that is 8 times as expensive as an arming sword. God. That is nasty. And that's the base price, mind you. Weight is 2.7 pounds. It weighs more than an arming sword. Rapiers are not light and nimble weapons. They are heavy, but nimble. 4, blunt, 1, no, 2. Energy 0, shock 1, because it's a pointy weapon, yes. The parry is 3, because the blade is crap. The reach is long, because the sword is long as balls. It's actually very long. Jesus! It's the same reach as a spear. That is nuts. Rapier's OP, please nerf. Melee, one-handed, weapon, balanced, no, dual. Rapier OP, please nerf. And edit cheat. That actually means that you will outrange a longsword with a rapier. Which makes sense, you'll do that in real life too. But it's just nasty. Malzord. It's a pokey stick. Aren't rapiers longer? Longer than the longsword? Yes. Which is why I said you'll outreach a longsword. Small sword. It is a melee weapon. And if I'm not incorrect, a small sword takes dual weapons? Yeah, it does. Shit. Which one of these is it? We'll see, I guess. It's relatively rare? No, it's common. Okay. Trader, Bazaar, and Master's Weaponsmith. C22! Wow, BMC22. BMC22. Price, pretty cheap. 9, yeah. G9. Quality, weight, 1.5 pounds, if I'm not mistaken. It could be 1.7. No, 1.1. 0/, 3 pierce, 0 blunt, 1 shock, 3 parry? 1 parry! Okay, you guess you don't parry with a small sword. Reach close, because they're relatively short. Yeah. It is, by the very definition, a sidearm. But yes, rapiers are usually about that much longer than a longsword. It obviously depends on the design and everything, but rapiers are usually quite a bit longer than a longsword.
Hey, Moose.
You got a key. Because you're cute. And also very tired. Should you go back to sleep? And now let's see if I actually got the skill right. Did not. It is the other one. It is the 72 one then. Dual weapons. Create a new one. And delete the old one. Maybe I should just use end instead of scrolling like a madman.
Bearded axe.
Bearded axe. Why are you so fuzzy? Type, it's a melee weapon. And it takes unbalanced melee weapons, which is what? One hand weapon? Heavy one-handed weapons. Block. Link. A bearded axe is relatively common though, right? Rare, apparently. Okay. I know my own world building. Trader. Master Weaponsmith. And the Bazaar. Okay. BU22. And if you wonder what these numbers are, they are related to how trade works not in CD10, but in Dark Shadows. The trader basically determines where you can find an item. The B is the weekly bazaar. And the number is a craftsman. So M22 is Master Weaponsmith. M23, I think, is Master Armorsmith. When it says U and the number, it means that it's unavailable, which means you actually need to go and order it. So you go to the craftsman, you pay, I don't know what you call that in English, but it's like a down pay, or like you deposit money because they're going to make the item. It's not the full price, but it's basically they keep that money if you cancel the order. And then you come back a couple of days or a week later or whenever they finish the item and you get it. So you need to order it. They don't just have them lying around. So that's how trade works in Dark Shadows. Bearded Axe is expensive, right? No, it's actually not. G6, that's pretty cheap. Weight, 1 pound, small axe. I guess that has a high slashing damage. Yeah, 3023. Parry value can't be that high. No, it's not. It's 2. And the reach is close. Medieval. One-handed weapon. Heavy. Heavy. I spell like Russian. What was that description? The description on the bearded axe? The description on the bearded axe is: shorter hand axes, called bearded axes, are around 4 to 6 palms long. So, 4 to 6 of these. No, 4 to 6 of these, sorry. Long, not very common on the battlefield, but they are relatively effective at... but are relatively effective at unarmored or lightly armored opponents, as they offer good power and penetration, and the bearded part of the blade can be used to dislodge or displace shields. They aren't quite as nimble as swords, but they do offer significantly more punch. These axes can be found at G6 for very basic variants, but they are commonly found as weapons of personal choice, and as such they are highly decorated, costing up to G8 and more. Wait, for the word? What do you mean? You mean this? I'm not sure what you're referring to anymore. Now I understand. I am, as I said, not in possession of a brain tonight. The down payment is basically you pay a small sum to the craftsman, and they start making the item. It's not the full sum, but it is a significant sum. It's kind of like a I don't know the English word for it, but it's basically they keep that money if you cancel the order. Yeah, an advancement? Yeah, that sounds familiar. It is basically if you're gonna buy a car, you pay them a small sum and then you go get the car and actually pay for it. That kind of deal thing. Deposit. Deposit feels correct. It is kind of a deposit, yes. Maze. A smashy, smashy weapon.
Maze. Melee weapon. Skill.
The 87 one? Trader. Bazaar and Master Weaponsmith, but apparently he has those available. So, this, but is it M or C? C. C22. Okay, not M. C22. Yeah, because craftsman. Duh. Oh, you say mace, not maze. I thought that smashy smashy was Gorn. No, mace with a C. Hey, Moose. Are you liking the keyboard? No, you're not? Okay, welcome back. Hi. I thought you was gonna stay down there, but apparently not. G7. Weight heavy. 2.5 pounds. Description: a specialized percussive weapon meant for use against those wearing armor. The mace offers great stopping power, and the power of the strike is enough to debilitate even those wearing heavy armor. Indeed, and for that reason has 0 slash damage. It has like 4... 2 bludgeoning? Oh, 2 bludgeoning but a lot of shock. Here's zero. I honestly should have three blunt. And four shock. The parry value is not great. Two, yeah. And the reach is close. That would be one amazing corn. Ha. Ha. Ah. This is what I have to live with. Delete. Wait, no, wait, hold up. Yes, this is the correct one. Are you gonna make up your mind today? Are you gonna be on the table or are you gonna be on me? Ow, ow, honey, ow. Put that claw somewhere else. You little noose. Oh, was it cozy? Apparently it was. I heard Brock sing. Warhammer, now that's a good weapon. Warhammer. Type melee weapon. Skill, it's gonna be that one. These are relatively rare, right? No, they're common. Okay. My bad. So that means they're in stock? No, they're not. The U22 trade group. I'm gonna guess G8. Yes. G8. Weight, not that heavy. 2.5 pounds, yeah.
War Smasher!
Exactly. You missed type melee. Oh, I did? Type melee weapon. No, I think I got it right. I hope so, anyway. A description. The Warhammer is more complex and developed weapon than the more common mace. Still a percussive weapon meant to combat armored opponents, the Warhammer offers greater range and more options. The hammerhead can deliver strong blunt force attacks or piercing attacks with the beak on the back of the head. Can even function as a pike with its spike on the top. Well, pike. Makeshift spear with the spike on its top. There we go. Text didn't show, it was light blue. Ah, yeah. No, if it's selected in a selection box, it goes really dark like that. That's why. Zero. Uno. Tres. Vier. The advantage of this one, though, is that it is longer than a mace. Parry value is also a little better, I think. No, it's actually the same. Parry 2, but it has normal range. Hey, Cadence. Why are you just sitting there looking at me like that? Hi. I know you're cute. What are you trying to tell me? Okay. Where's your sister, by the way? There she is. Hi. She was just sitting right in front of my keyboard with her front paws on the keyboard and just looking at me. And I was like, what do you want? It was very adorable. Yes, it was. Hi, welcome back. I'm tempted to say that Mises are the best pets, but there are many pets that are awesome, but Mises are seriously cute. Wood axe. It is technically a weapon. Very common. Everybody has one, and you can get them pretty much everywhere. Market, Master Blacksmith, and Village. So, Market. That's M? Yeah. Market. Master Blacksmith, which is 14? 15. and in villages. The price is like what, G3? G6? Holy god!
That's expensive for a freaking wood axe!
A reach clause, and it's heavy as all balls. Yeah, 5 pounds. It is not the best or most balanced weapon. It's, I would not recommend using it for combat. It's not what it is for. Those are my tissues. Would you not murder those? I use them to wipe up after I have supper. Because I'm a messy guy and I mess up my desk. Thank you. The heavy wood axe is primarily meant as a tool to fell trees, split wood, and hammer spikes into the ground. It's not designed as a weapon, but can be used as one in a pinch. Heavy and cumbersome, this highly unbalanced weapon means you are attacking at +2 difficulty. Hello. Welcome back. Or however long you're staying before you're leaving again. 3, 0, 3, and I'm gonna guess it has a humongous blunt shock value. Yeah, 3. Parry, does it even have a parry? 3? Are you Chris? No. No. That's gonna be a 1. You cannot defend yourself with that very well. And it's also short. Delete. What's the next one? Kaiser. Now that's a good weapon. Kaiser. It's one of the better weapons. Kaiser. Type melee weapon. Skill is bastard weapons. And I do not off the top of my head remember what that skill has. Bastard. Block link. Availability. It's very rare, right? No, it's just rare. You're doing the cute thing again. Why are you doing the cute thing? And this is going to be a special order on the bazaar. Yeah, definitely. Price. Gloriously expensive. G12. 12. That is like, you can get a war horse for that price. Weight 3.3 pounds. Remember that. That just happened. No! Don't fall out, you stupid moose! What are you doing? I was just typing and she just ran up my sleeve. Okay. You gonna get out again? Oh, she did get out, but... Well, yeah, that is a bot. That is a mouse bot. But this is her sister. There is now a sister in here instead. Can you both get out of my sleeve? So I can type. Thank you. I appreciate you. Fine, you can live in the sleeve if you want, I guess. The mighty Kaiser is a large two-handed messer. Single-edged, this large cleaver weapon is extremely well-balanced and nimble for its size, offering great range, reach, devastating cuts, and a huge defensive potential. This expensive weapon is the first choice for most champions and swordsmen. Me and Seth... Oh, aren't you bothered about them making doo-doos in your hot hoodie? No, that's just something you get used to when you have rodents. Basically, they do pee too. Arguably, these two don't actually make that much of a mess compared to the other mice in that one. They are the messy ones. But, I mean, they do pee and they do poop pretty much everywhere at any time. But their poop doesn't smell much, and it's very, very dry. So generally, it doesn't smear, and it doesn't smell. It doesn't stick to things. Well, it does stick to things because it's a little bit jelly on the outside. But it's not smeary, and it doesn't smell a lot if you don't crush them. So you can, they're basically like rabbit's poop. You can just pick them up and throw them away. The pee is a little bit worse. It smells like hot popcorn. So you need to basically rinse through your clothes after you've had the meeses in it. You don't generally need to wash them unless they peed on it and it stayed there for a long time. Then it smells a lot. But if it's just like this, I have them for like an hour or two, then I can just go and thoroughly rinse through the shirt and it's fine to use again. So no, it doesn't bother me much. And when they run around the desk, sure, they poop a bit, but it's just to pick it up and throw it away. So, it's not a big deal. I mean, they're like this big, so. The poops are small. 5213. But I guess if you are queasy about those things, then yes, in that case it is a problem, but generally not. I don't care anyway. If their poop would become in a way that would bother me, I would probably take them to the veterinary because then they're not healthy. If it smells bad or is very runny, then take them to the vet because then they're not healthy. Are the puddles small too? Yes, very. Generally, they will not pee when they're outside of the cage. As in, they will not relieve themselves. They'll usually do that in their cage. They have a designated corner or somewhere where they actually pee. What they do outside is scent marking, which is like a drop or two. So, it also doesn't smell as much ammonia as their actual pee does. It's more of a warm popcorn smell. Is this a dual weapon? No. Now it's a bastard weapon. I'm comparing the gerbils and they pee 1 to 2 centimeter puddles together with poop, so it's a bit more messy. Yeah, I can understand that. And one of my mice, the very, very young one, Melody, the tiny one, she really hasn't learned the whole we pee in the cage yet, so she can make like small puddles on the desk, for instance, when she's out, or actually pee on you when she's on you. But none of my other mice do that. Not even the messy ones do that. So they just don't pee much when they're outside of the cage. That's the Kaither, which we should remove. And then we have the Longsword, which I believe I've already made. If I'm not wrong. Longsword. Yep, it's right there. Have I filled everything out, however? I have. Very good. In that case, we can just remove this one. Because it's done already. Pike. That is a long stick. It's a heavy pole arm. Pike. Mechle weapon. Skill. That's gonna be heavy pole arms. Convenient. Yeah, it is. And it also makes them less messy to be around. Otherwise, not toilet-trained animals like birds and rodents are usually kind of messy. And, of course, a mouse is going to be messier than, say, a cat. Depends on your cat. But still. But it's not bad because their poops and pees are so small that you can easily clean them up. And they are very snuggly. No, 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 no. Hi, honey. She's like, stop messing with me. I'm trying to explore. Pike, where do you get that? Master Weaponsmith only. U22. And the price is can't be that expensive. It's G4. Yeah. Weight a lot. 9 pounds, yes. 4.5 kilos. It's a long stick. It's a yeah, it's a little more than a very long stick with a spearhead on the end. Exactly that. Hello, Kajetan. Welcome back. Ow, 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 ow. Why does this have slashing damage? Now I'm confused. It should have 1 slashing. 4 pierce. 2 blunt, yeah. Shock, not a lot. 2. Parry value, 1. And reach is very long. It's a long stick with a spear on the end. Medieval. It's not one-handed, it's two-handed. Polearm. And it's a heavy polearm. I'm probably late. Well, we've been going for an hour, so that depends on your definition of late. Ow, ow, ow. You're doing the claw thing again. Honey, please, stop. Ow. Am I just sensitive today, or have your claws gotten sharper? Eeh. Where did you find candy back there? Did you stash candy in my hoodie? Really? Okay. Pitchfork. Who knows? Oh, you look tired. Is it time to go home and sleep? It just might be. Candy stash, exactly. Pitchfork. That is legally a weapon. Pitchfork type, melee weapon. Skill, heavy polearms? I'm gonna guess. Yeah.
Heavy polearms.
Oh my word, the yawning.
It's happening. Very common, I would assume. It's a friggin' pitchfork. Yeah. Market and the Master Blathsmith. Market, Master Blathsmith, Village. I technically, probably not. I mean, maybe. Trade group, G2? 3? 2. G2, quality, weight a ton. Pitchforks are heavy. 3 pounds. No. 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 That can't be right. What bagger and her grip. That is not at all what I was after. This, none of this had anything to do with a pitchfork. What is the weight of a pitchfork? Let's take it in English. Really? Okay. I mean, it's not 3 pounds, it's more like 5 pounds, but still, that's a lot lighter than I thought, I must admit. Why do I keep clicking the long one? What are the stats? Slashing 212. Oui. Zero. Oops. Zero. Two. No, 2, 1. So, parry value is like what? 1? How is the parry value 2? Okay, I can see why. The bridge is long though, right? Yeah. Medieval. One-handed weapon. It's not a one-handed weapon. It's a heavy. And it's it's technically a polearm. Are you two gonna make up your mind anytime soon? Like, a second ago, you were so tired you were literally falling asleep on your face, and now you're shuffling all over the place. How do you want it? Do you want to go home, or... What's going on? Poleaxe. The world's most OP weapon. Poleaxe. Type. Melee weapon. And the skill is... light polearms? No, it's heavy polearms. Okay. That is just the cutest, though. And she's just hanging her head out like that. You're adorable. Poleaxe, as an axe on a spear? Well, it's technically more like a hammer on a spear, but yes. And it's not a spear, it's more like a quarterstaff. It's a quarterstaff with a hammer on the end and a spear on the other. Kinda. Poleaxe. That thing. That's a poleaxe. It's a very brutal weapon. Boop. Wow, it should not have 5 slashing damage. It is actually... the values need to change a bit. It's heavy polearm though, so... heavy pole... it's an oversized meat tenderizer. Yep! Correct! I just googled. The Polish name has nothing to do with either an axe or a hammer. That's fair. And it's not pole axe, as most people think. It's pole axe, which P-O-L-L axe. I don't know the etymology behind it, I just know that's how you spell it. Poleaxe, not poleaxe. This is rare, right? No, it's common. It shouldn't be, it should be rare. It is a sophisticated weapon, it should be rare. Bazaar and Master Weaponsmith. That seems reasonable, though. Bazaar and Master Weaponsmith. Trade group, expensive. Group 7, I'm gonna say it's actually a group 9. Heavyweight, 7 pounds. According to Wikipedia, pole and pole are both correct. Well, thank you, Wikipedia. Slash, it does technically sometimes have an axe head on it, but it's not really a slashing weapon, it's more for breaking armor. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna shift the numbers around. I'm gonna give it a slash of 3, a pierce of 3, and a blunt of 5, because this is a blunt weapon. And the shock should be 4. If it's not 4, it should be 4. The parry value is actually relatively high too, because it is a staff. It's a really, really good weapon with long reach. If you like blunt weapons, a poleaxe is not a bad pickup. Medieval heavy weapon, polearm. Delete. You wanna go home? You kind of seem like you want to go home. Or are you just having a washing party? Okay. Fine. Be a moose.
War axe.
That is the big two-handed axe, right? Yep. War axe. Type, melee weapon, skill, that's gonna be... It is heavy pole arm, right? Yes. Availability rare. I don't think that's that common. Correct. It's the same traders as always in the trade group, though. Group 7, it's not that expensive. G7. Wait, not that heavy. 5 pounds. Yep, not that heavy. Description. The war axe is relatively rare and found mostly among raiders. It's a long axe with a very broad and large head mounted on it. It's surprisingly nimble for its size, mainly due to the very thin axe blade. While relatively long, it offers far less reach than specialized long-range weapons, such as the pole axe.
Yes!
This is correct. And I just realized I should probably check the stats before I do anything. Four... How does this have three piercing? Are you serious? 413, dude. 413. It's a two-handed axe. 4 bludgeoning is probably reasonable. No. 3. Parry value. It is a staff, so 3 seems reasonable. Reach long. No, it's normal. Okay. Fine. Mechdival. Heavy polearm. That's my bottle. Leave my bottle alone. But thank you for reminding me that I should drink. Really? She bit my nose. I mean, not hard, but she nibbled my nose. Okay. Piercing is like stabby stab. Yes. Piercing is like stabby stab. So you have slashing, which is basically just chopping someone with a sword or a cleaver, and then you have stabby stabby, which is piercing, and then you have blunt, which is hitting someone with a stick. She numbed me. I guess that is the mouse equivalent of a kiss. I'm not sure. The parry. Did I do everything? Yes. Plus one shock to top limb by moves. Correct. I was not prepared for that. Wait, hold on. Which weapon is this? That's the war axe. Okay, correct. Okay, move. Next one, which is the quarter staff, which is also a very handy weapon. Quarter staff. Because I would say a battle axe would be able to pierce pretty good, but it's more of a choppy chop. It's slashing damage. It's not like pinpoint piercing. You won't go through it like a ring mail with it, for instance. Or mail. It will probably hurt someone wearing the mail because the blunt impact force of the axe is pretty substantial, but it's not piercing damage. Interestingly enough, pistols, like if you shoot someone in the CD10 system, pistols deal blunt damage most of the time. Shotguns deal slashing damage, but armor-piercing ammunition deals piercing damage. So it's less about reality and more about game mechanics, but it makes sense on a certain level. You gonna go up here again? No? You're not? You're just gonna be... Miss Explorimus. It is not time to explore right now. I'm trying to work. And I would appreciate it if you would cooperate. Ah! Determimus! Okay, fine. Melee weapon. Does this count as a heavy or a light polearm? It's a light polearm.
Light polarmo.
Slash is like cutting ham, piercing is like putting meat on a skewer, and blunt is like hitting someone with a brick. Those are not bad likenesses. I agree.
I agree.
What was this? Course. That's a new passare. Okay. What is that? Very common. You can find this virtually everywhere. Market and master weaponsmith. Okay. Shotted staff, sure. Market, master weaponsmith. Price is not a lot. Group 1. That's pushing it, dude. A good quarterstaff is at least G3. Weight, 2 pounds. It's probably closer to 3 pounds? Honestly? It's a stick. It deals virtually no slashing damage, no piercing damage, but it deals a lot of bludgeoning damage. So 0, 0, 3, and probably a lot of shock. So 3 there too. Parry value is decent because it's a stick, so I'm gonna give it 3. Reach is long because it's a staff. Mechdival, and it's a light polearm. Next. Delete the old. Delete. Spear! And thus we come to the most OP weapon in all of Selenia. The melee weapon. It uses light polearms. It is relatively common. It is BU-22, yes?
No, it is not. It is MC-22.
Oh. I think it said C-15 on the last one. C-22. Hey. This Moose is weird. He decided that my right shoulder should always smell of him. Never the left one, only the right one. Because now it smells right. I hate you. Just so you know. Fucking pundry today. It's off the scale. The trade group for the spear is what? 3. Same G4. Quality. No, the weight. What is the weight? It weighs about 2 pounds. And I did it again. Band, get out. Exactly. Band, get out. A spear has 1, 2 slashing damage, 4 piercing damage, and 2 blunt. The other Mises are awake too. If Tomlin wants to start banning people for puns, that's on him. No, I don't, but it's a good meme. Banned, get out. Protection value is gonna be 2. The reach is going to be very long for a spear. If a rapier is long, then the spear should probably be very long. Yes? You think? Okay, for now, let's leave it alone. That I might change that later. Mechdival Light Polarm. He has a love-hate relationship to puns. This is correct. I laugh at them, and then it hurts my soul that I laughed at them. Dagger. The most underestimated weapon in all games. Like, it's what you always start with, and it's always useless. Good news, daggers are not useless in CD10. Daggers are dangerous. Melee weapon. Skill. Brawl, I believe. So I'm gonna have to go and pull paste that and then find Brawl. Skill used. Brawl. Not to rogues and WoW, it's your worst enemy. Yeah, availability for daggers is pretty common, I would say. Because the thing is, a dagger is, what, 30-ish centimeters long? If you stab someone in the ribcage with a 30-centimeter long dagger, it's not going to matter if you stab them with the dagger or if you stab them with a longsword. Because what happens after a while is that, you see, the other end comes out the back of the person, and then it doesn't do any more damage. You can keep stabbing with your longsword, but it doesn't gonna do anything. It doesn't do more damage just because you stab someone with a longer blade. D&D daggers are useless, even when they would make the most sense for combat. Yep. I hate that, which is why I made daggers useful. Their main disadvantage is the reach. Like, you can't reach, but if you can get into wrestling range with someone who has, like, a sword or a spear, the person with the sword or the spear will have to drop the sword or the spear to wrestle with you, and you can stab them while they have to wrestle with their hands. But with a longer blade, you can cut someone in half. Correct. But he's going to die either way. If you get stabbed through the chest, or if you get cut in half, you're still dead. This is where daggers are mainly as a hidden weapon. I honestly would like to see someone hide a dagger. Have you seen a proper war dagger? They're like this long. How do you hide that? What am I fishing after? Oh, that's what I'm fishing after. Okay, Bazaar Market and Master Weaponsmith. Bazaar Market, Master Weaponsmith. And it's relatively cheap. Group 4, yes. Assassin's Creed intensifies. The one game where it isn't, where daggers aren't useless. And in my boot, where it has a pretty decoration along the back of my dress. That works. Though in your boot, then you would have to have pretty tall boots. Or a short dagger, I guess. That works too. Slashing damage on daggers isn't great. It's 2. But the stab damage is great. It's 3. The blunt is not great. But it's 1. Shock 2. Parry value for a dagger is decent. But it's short. So it doesn't really protect much. But it does have grappling reach, which is great. Because that means you can use it in actual wrestling. Medieval melee grappling. 1-handed. Daggers are a nice backup weapon. It probably isn't the best primary weapon, but it's a great backup weapon. The dress reference is the Wonder Woman where she hit a sword that way, which was a bit pushy. And I've also seen Jill's video on that, and it was funny. We carry just the hilt and make the blade with magic. That would require a world that has magic. A bat. For some reason, I read that as the flying creature. Like, why is a bat a weapon? What are we, Batman? But no, not that kind of bat.
Make a new one?
A bat. Type melee weapon. Skill. Well, either it's a heavy one-handed weapon, or it's a melee weapon. It depends on the setting. But I think a bat technically exists only in modern settings in that sense, so it should be melee weapon. Melee weapons. Oh, by the way, Lorraine, did you replace your skill? In Dragon Age Origins, the daggers are worn on the back of the rogue like swords. That has to be so awkward. It's like you have to reach all the way back to get a dagger, and then also you have to put it back there. It's like, I've seen back scabbards that work. I mean, Shadiversity made videos of it, and it's like, sure, it wasn't done historically, but it works if you do it right. But the question is, why? It's so much more awkward than having a side scabbard. I believe I did for a Nilar. Okay, that's good. Just making sure so you don't run around with a useless skill. Especially not a plus 6 one. That would be unfortunate. Price, 80 credits. Or was it 50 credits? 80. Trader, any sports store. Sports store. Quality, the weight of a bat. It's like, what, a kilo? Witcher wears the swords on his back. I know! And he does not have back scabbards that work. But I also accept the fact that it looks cool, so I guess that's why. And trust me, I have LARPed and I had my sword on the back. I had to have my friend draw my sword for me because I couldn't. It was not ideal in combat, let me tell you that. Like, I can't draw my sword. Zero. Actually, I'm gonna do that. That. And the blunt is like, what, 3? 2. Oh. Just 4 shock, though, which is great. Parry value is 2. Not great. Reach is normal. In Blade and Soul, the rogue class wears the daggers horizontally right above the booty. Oh, that classic one. Again, not very practical. It's like, where are they? Also, they have to be pretty stuck, because if they're horizontal, there's a risk they'll fall out when you move and wiggle around. Also, can you imagine sitting down with that? If you have a side scabbard, you can just shuffle the side scabbard next to your chair. Instead of having them right in the fuck in your back. Like, oh, never mind, I forgot my daggers. This is uncomfortable. There's always a risk of cutting your own head when drawing a sword from the back. Well, I would expect anyone who has a back scabbard is trained enough to not chop their own head off when they pull the sword. Because in that case, we could make the argument there's a real chance of chopping your left hand off when you draw a sword. And I've never done that, and I've worn a sword a lot. Yes, I own swords. What is this? This is a melee weapon. Medieval melee. It's not medieval, it's modern. Modern melee. Blunt. I always figured the greatsword backscabbard was more like you're walking around in town with it and not actually expecting to use it, but you still need to have the weapon for whatever reason. The thing is, great swords are pole arms. They're used on the battlefield, not in town. So you wouldn't be carrying your great sword in town. You would be carrying a side sword, a dagger, or at worst, an arming sword. Or maybe a small sword. It depends on the time period. But the great sword is a battlefield weapon. You wouldn't wear it in town. And besides, you'd never wear a greatsword anyway. Every picture we have of greatswords, they're worn or they are carried with the hand on the quillons and the blade resting on the shoulder, just like you would a spear, for instance. I think having daggers at the back of your waist works better for women, because we are more shaped for them to fit there. If you are shaped for them to fit there, sure. I'm not. Oh, it has to be number. Okay, 00 then. Or at least I shouldn't be. My poor posture not included. Bredu. This is a modern weapon. Blade. Type melee weapon. Skill. This is the last one I added. Availability. Common. And to be fair, Geralt is always ready to defend himself. Yeah. This is true. Price, 200 credits. Most weapons and tool stores. He pretty much has to. Yep. The weight of a blade is about 0.8 kilos. Okay, so both the mice have now fallen asleep. So they're sleeping in my hoodie. Monsters and people dislike him. Yeah. They do. What is the damage? 2212. Dos. Harry was 3. Reach close. Modern. Melee blunt, and it's also a weapon. Should probably have that included in there. Did the Moses fall asleep? I asked the second before you asked, because of course Twist is latency, yeah. But yeah, they're asleep. They're in my hoodie, sleeping. They're not moving in the slightest. They are dead. So, yes, they're sleeping. I told one of my players that he wears his on his back because he is in town while passing through the next place or to get back home. Personal weapon is longsword. Once out of town, he assumes to have his weapon out because the alternative would take too long. Imagine having to carry your weapon in your hand constantly. I don't have to. I did that in the military. Never mind. Okay, that's not entirely true. We did have slings for our weapons, but still. Knife. New. Knife. Melee weapon. Brawl. Fuck, I think I might have Shiza. I have to check this. Imagine back scavenger like backpack for sword. I don't know. I just inherently don't like back scabbards. Bastard weapons. New. No, it's melee weapon. Bastard weapons, sure, dude. Hey. Because you can't really fit in your bag, except if you're Mario or someone, or Zelda, I suppose. Or anyone with an infinite pack. What are bastard weapons? Weapons for bastards? bastard weapons are... It's derived from the term bastard sword, which is essentially a long sword with a shorter blade, or an arming sword with a longer handle. So it's essentially a one-handed sword that you can use in two hands. Or it's a two-handed sword that you can use in one hand. It sort of straddles the line between a long sword, which is technically also a weapon you can use in one hand, but you generally don't. But it is shorter and easier to use in one hand. That's a bastard weapon.
Weapons for Jon Snow.
Had to let the bot okay that. Yeah, bastard is probably not an acceptable term in most cases. She's way more than bad. Way more badass than a Link usually. Yeah, except in Breath of the Wild. When she speaks. That hurts my soul! Oh, my poor Zelda, what did they do to you? Oh, never mind, you gave her the Metroid Other M treatment. Oh, that's cool. Or is this medieval? No, it isn't. 200 credits? No, it's 100 credits. I mean, she managed to keep Ganondorf under somewhat control for 100 years. Yeah, I just mean that every time she speaks, I want to kill myself. Because, holy Christ, she sounds like a schoolgirl who has zero self-confidence and needs a hero to save her. It's painful to listen to her speak. And, mind you, I listened to an interview with the voice actress who did the Zelda's voice, and it's not her fault. She tried really hard to make Zelda sound confident and strong and independent, but the directors for the game kept making her retake all the takes and telling her to be more vulnerable, because fuck Japan. Okay, that came out wrong, but fuck Nintendo? Anyway, they have a habit of just ruining every female character ever. If you've ever seen Metroid Other M and what they did to Samus Aran in that game... Oh... Can we have a strong female character? Nintendo says no. I think we might get to see a more strong Zelda in the next... Yeah, I mean... The problem is, even if she's badass, if you keep sounding like that, it's just gonna be annoying. Just let her be strong, man. Or if you're gonna make an innocent, cute girl, make her kind of like Aerith, who has some form of agency. Just don't make her a wet noodle, please. Where did my knife go? There's my knife. 2212. And it's grappling. There you go. Modern melee. I'm just gonna go with slashing, piercing. Let her sound strong, exactly. I think in the original Breath of the Wild, her story was that she was losing confidence in herself with the pressures until the end, and then she's tired and weakened after a century? Yeah. But so is Urbosa, and they gave Urbosa a badass voice. So it's like... Also, Zelda in the previous games was badass, except for the third one for some reason. In the third one, she was just a damsel in distress, but in the first and the second one, Zelda was pretty badass. Especially in the comics. That's interesting, by the way. In the comics and in the cartoon, Zelda was the one who was badass, and Link was the moron. Which third one? Link to the Past. Did there she's kind of just, oh no, I got kidnapped, please save me. And then, oh no, I got kidnapped again, and now I'm dispersed. My favorite Zelda game is Twilight Princess. Still haven't played that one. I like the graphics though, from what I've seen from screenshots and stuff. Delete sheet. Oh, did you wake up again? Maybe I should go poke you, put you in your cage. Okay, so that's all the melee weapons. Moved from the old system to the new system. So next I need to do ranged weapons and then armors. And then we have moved everything to the new system and we can delete the old template that is shite. Which is great. Twilight Princess Zelda is pretty bamf. Same, I've not played much of Skyward Sword, but the Zelda dialogue I found there so far had me cringing as well. I love Link Between Worlds or Minish Cap, both super games. I played neither. I kinda fell out of Nintendo games when they started making new consoles every third year, and I didn't bother buying them because I had a PC. The NES and SNES are the Nintendo games I'm most familiar with. Anything past that, I never really played. Because I'm old. And I didn't get the consoles. I've never really been a console player. I've been a PC player since I was like 5 years old when we got a 5150, IBM 5150. Ever since then, I've really been a PC player. I had a short stint into NES when the NES came out in 1980. It came out in Sweden in 86 or 87, I think. And then I got one for my 8th birthday, so I had an NES and about 10 or 12 games that I accumulated over the years. So in my early teens, I did a lot of NES rather than PC, because the PC kind of sucked then, but then came like Pentium and MMX and 3D acceleration, and from then on it was just PC all the way. I'm not kidding you when I say that my login screen for this computer is a ginormous synthwave retrowave colored image, kind of like the one behind me, that just says PC Master Race. It's very tongue-in-cheek, obviously, but I'm definitely a PC gamer. I don't do consoles because 90% of the times, if a game exists on both PC and console, you're getting a subpar experience on the console. Not necessarily a bad experience, but compared to the PC, it's worse. There are exceptions though, like the first Dark Souls. God, that PC port was terrible. But recently, Cyberpunk, which I heard was pretty shite on consoles. I like handhelds because this seems like I'm always traveling or at someone's place. Yeah, if I was traveling more, I would probably be that too. But for now, as seldomly as I travel, mobile games keep me entertained for that little journey. But can it run Crysis? That's a classic. Good morning. Where are you going? There are easier ways to go from that side to that side. But you chose a really strange route. Okay, whatever. Not on that Google console. Stadia? I hear most things run great on Stadia. The problem is that you have to have really good internet and also it doesn't have any games. Okay, well, I'm done with the things for today, for the items stuffs, because... Well, that was all I was going to do today, so we're done. And I do believe that World Anvil goes online in about 10 minutes, so why don't we do a little bit of an AMA? Where you can ask me anything. And that involves, like, me, game-making, games, retro games, TTRPGs, storytelling, anything. Ask me anything. How's your day? Been very tired today. But it is also the end of the week for me, because tomorrow I have the day off because I'm going to therapy. Yes, I go to therapy because I'm a broken motherfucker. So I get to sleep in tomorrow, which is great. Is the CD10 PDF ready? No, it's not ready. It is, however, in the works. It's not ready, but it is in the works. So let's see if I can show you, actually. That's gonna have to be there. I'm gonna set that to height, and then see if I can... How does... I'm gonna have to go there, and I'm gonna go to the window capture. And let's... Why does that not show? Oh, there it is. Well, as you can see, it's in the works. I'm working on it. It will hopefully be ready someday. And I'm saying someday because I genuinely don't know when it's going to be ready. Because right now I'm in the design process of it. I'm like picking out fonts and picking out how headers are gonna look, how info boxes are going to look, and the art isn't final. It's a lot more work to do, but it's in the works. I am the big jelly of what?
I'm done with coding. Woo!
Congratulations and welcome back to the awesomeness. We're doing a little bit of an AMA here because I finished with the weapons. I didn't expect to finish today, but we did. So I'm just trying to hold out until World Anvil comes online and takes over. So we're doing an AMA. So if you have any questions, Hefe, ask me. You having tomorrow off? Well, I have tomorrow off from work because I have therapy. So it's you win some, you lose some. But I shouldn't say that therapy is losing some, because while it is extremely tiring and exhausting to go to therapy, it also does help. It does make things better. My life has improved a lot since I started going on these therapy things. Just ask my fiance. How do you get your game in the hands of players? Well, for right now, the game is in beta. And it is a closed beta, so the only ones who are actually playing it is my group that I picked out from my Patreons, the ones rotating up there. The Keeper of Tales are the ones that I picked my players from. So we're running a closed beta right now. CD10 Core, which is like the core system, is free, so you can use it yourself. It's just that the guides aren't written for it yet, really. It does exist here on World Anvil, but the PDF isn't done, for instance. So you have to do online referencing for everything. So how do I get it into the hands of my players? It's on World Anvil. But once CD10 Core is done, like entirely, and we have done all the balancing passes and everything, then there's going to be a PDF that you can download and just hand out. There's going to be one printable and one online version, or one reference version, I guess. With less art and stuff, so you can just print it out. And then once that's done, I'm gonna dive back into CD10 Advanced, which is the paid version. And that's gonna be a long time before that's finished. So that's how I get it into the hands of my players. I just link them to CD10. That's kind of how that works. Which is, by the way, what? That is not... I love copy-pasting sometimes. It's amazingly. There. That. Is there actually any game that is only on console that you would like to play? No, not at the moment. Because the one game that was only on console that I did want to play, I have played. Because, see, my fiancé has a PS4. So I can play console games there. And the only two games I wanted to play that were console exclusives were Bloodborne and Horizon Zero Dawn. And I finished Bloodborne several times. I think I played through it 7 times because I got every single achievement. I found every single item. It's just I played it through. And then Horizon Zero Dawn I haven't really started on. I have played for a couple of hours, but then the PC version came out and I haven't dived into it yet. I don't really have the time, but I'm planning to. Ghost of Tsushima? Not my kind of game, really. I mean, it's very Horizon Zero Dawn-y, but it interests me less because the reason I want to play Horizon Zero Dawn is for the story mostly. Because I like post-apocalyptic sci-fi stuff, and Ghost of Tsushima doesn't have a story that grips me. And the whole open world slashy slashy game is not a kind of game that I enjoy. Or perhaps back for World Evil. Thanks for streams. Thank you for showing up and for subscribing, Hef. I appreciate the support, my man. How have you played Horizon Zero Dawn before the PC version? You haven't played it here. I have. I played at your place for like probably an hour, but you've forgotten. Also, I've seen you play. You like post-apocalyptic sci-fi? I wouldn't have guessed. No. Really? Could it have something to do with the world I'm building? Nah, not at all. So the dice is 0 to 9. Interesting take on using a 0 instead of a 10. Yeah, it is. Rolling a 0 is not good. It is an oh shit moment. Watching others play is a good way to gauge if you would enjoy something. Yeah, it's true. No, you haven't. You killed 2 razor kitties for me. That took like an hour. No, it feels like I've played it, but I probably haven't played it more than that. You're probably right. Exploding zeros and exploding nines. Well, the zero is technically not exploding. The zero is just you fail and now you need to not fumble. The nine is true exploding, though. That's true. I used to have exploding zeros. So basically you'd roll a zero and it would reduce your entire... Basically, you would calculate your success by just counting the numbers, and each zero would reduce one success level. So it would go from like success to status quo to fail to fumble. And I had like 9 success levels, or it was 10. It was super complex and absolutely arduous, and it made for rolling a lot, and I didn't like it, so I baked it down to what we have today. And I'm still considering baking it down even more. But considering how seldomly a zero actually comes up in gameplay, I don't hate it. It works. You weren't interested in Baldur's Gate 3, right? No. I know how iconic Baldur's Gate is, but I played the first one and I made it 20 minutes in before I hated the guts out of it. I tried playing Knights of the Old Republic, which is basically the same gameplay, but it's Star Wars and I really love Star Wars. And I played that for like 3 hours and I ended up hating it because the combat is so stupid. I hate the combat. And I mean, that probably ties into that I hate D&D as a combat system because that's literally D&D, but in a computer game. So I just couldn't stand it. So no, Baldur's Gate 3 is probably not going to be something that ends up on my computer. I tried playing Divinity Original Sin. And while I like the game and I like the flexibility, I hate the combat. And it's like 90% combat, so... I'm just gonna give up on those types of games, I think. I rolled 0 twice in an RP session. Yeah, I mean, I said they don't happen that often. I didn't say they don't happen at all. To be fair, I've spent hours trying to take on gators in one area with all my trap setups and such. Since I have to fight like 5 at once, ouch. Oh yeah, the gators. Oh, yeah, they're nasty. I do remember those. Anyway, It looks like World Anvil is finally online, so I'm going to throw you people all over there. I rolled like 4 times that whole session. Okay, fine. You rolled half. That's not often, is it? I'm gonna send my Mises home.